I want to share with you, as a conclusion here, three recent examples that I have seen that you see where the source of the alleged sectarianism in Yemen is. Firstly, last year I attended a very respectable establishment-connected think tank here in the UK where a lot of Yemenis were invited to discuss the Yemen problem. What I saw there, I and a colleague attended there, what I saw there was a collection of what we call in, what we call in Arabic, murtazaqa, i.e. paid people, of Yemenis who will take petrodollars any day and kill their own mothers if necessary. Partly because they've been Wahhabi brainwashed that tells them you can kill your parents if they pray differently from you. You can kill your parents if they do something differently from you. That's what Wahhabism says, by the way. Children have been killing their parents in Saudi Arabia in recent months. So in this seemingly respectable think tank, they had this group of paid mercenaries, if you like. One group is saying Taiz has to be an independent state, please. Another group is saying Aden is completely separate from Mukalla and the rest of Hadhramaut, so it has to be an independent region. So does Al-Jawf and Marib. And Marib, oh, our history is different. We go back to Sheba. And I sat there baffled completely, thinking this respectable think tank collecting this hodgepodge of ragamuffins in here to discuss this very important issue of a whole nation and its 26 million population. What kind of a joke is that? Now, I realized when I analyzed the position that these people were deliberately brought in there. They were deliberately brought in there to justify the false argument that the Yemenis can't agree with each other. They have sectarianism. The sectarianism that I had witnessed in this seemingly respectable think tank was along the lines of regionalism, which I reject, which I know is not reality, because I know the tribes of the Yemen are with the government, current government of the Yemen, that is Ansarullah and the Congress Party, along with the tribes and the army. So, second example I had is I was phoned by the BBC, who obviously doesn't like people who are against the war in Yemen to be appearing there. Of course, I am better at English because that's the language that I have grown up in and I use more often. I can speak Arabic, but it's not as good, especially the classical Arabic. So the BBC, the Arabic version, invited me to come and talk. I thought, yeah, Arabic, English, that's fine. I will speak the street language, which is what I'm good at in Arabic. And so this lady phones me up and tells me, oh, we would like to host you. We heard a lot about you, and we want you to come and join in our program. I said, yes, by all means. And she said, are you against the war? I said, definitely, I'm against the war. And she then says to me, who are you for? I said, I'm for the Yemen. She says, but no, but who are you for specifically? I said, I'm for the Yemen, the whole of Yemen. And I said, I'm from the south, but I'm for the whole of the Yemen. She says, but no, 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 we want you to choose somebody. I said, like if you could say, like you are with the Houthi, that would be useful. What? This woman in the BBC is telling me to be sectarian, and I'm telling her I'm for the whole country. I can't discriminate against my brothers in the north, south, east, west. Every Yemeni's life matters to me. And every inch of Yemen matters to me. It has to be protected and given as a matter of... And new people are following them. And this is so amazing. This reminds me of the creators of sect in Ahmad known, sect in Islam known as Ahmadiyya. We know the funding they had originally to help them separate from the rest of Islamic schools. The same people who also created the Ismaili division of the Aga Khan type have also now come to the Yemen and pouring money in to create more sectarianism because they're not seeing enough division in the Yemen. They're seeing millions of people coming to Sana'a marching, saying, we are for even Jewish community children, I saw yesterday. Beautiful Orthodox Jewish Yemenis in the streets waving the flag. Now, I have a news for these shaitans, these human shaitans with lots of money and machines and rotten other traitors, that no matter what they do and what they say, okay, there is a power above them, and that's the power of God that will keep the Yemen united with this. Whether they like it or not, Yemen is going to decide its own future. Yemen is going to be a democratic, independent, civil society. No more dictation from brutal dictators. Thank you very much.